38절부터 42절입니다.
Verses 38 through 42.
요한복음 19장 38절에 42절을 우리 교독을 하도록 하겠습니다.
We'll have responsive reading.
아리마대 사람 요셉은 예수의 제자이나 유대인들이 두려워 그것을 숨기더니 이 일 후에 빌라도에게 예수의 시체를 가져가기를 구하매 빌라도가 허락하는지라 이에 가서 예수의 시체를 가져가니라.
Nicodemus also, who earlier had come to Jesus by night, came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloe, about 75 pounds in weight.
유대인의 장례 법대로 그의 향품과 함께 세마포로 쌌더라.
Now in the place where he was crucified there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb in which no one had yet been laid. Let us read together. So because of the Jewish day of preparation, since the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus there. Amen. Let us bless each other. Be at peace. You're the missionaries to save the world.
그 황무한 땅을 기업으로 누리십시다.
Let us enjoy the inheritance of the desolate heritage. Hallelujah.
우리는 주님의 은총 아래 있는 자입니다.
We are the people who are underneath the
하나님께서 은총 아래 있는 저와 여러분을
a gift of God.
기억하고 인도하십니다.
And to those people, God will absolutely lead.
오늘도 하나님의 은총 입은 자로 최고의 하나님의 인도를 받는 귀중한 예배로
And we have been called to this worship as those people.
이 시간이 한 주간을 놓고 응답부터 먼저 확인하는 축복의 예배가 되기를 주의 이름으로 축복합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord. May this worship be the time where you first see the answers throughout the week.
내가 바라고 소원하는 인생의 계획과 또 삶의 목적이 무엇입니까?
What is the wish and the life plans and the goal for my life is? We must always examine that.
정말 내 중심에 내가 바라고 있는 우리의 인생의 소원이 무엇이고
What is the will that I have inside of my life? And why do we live on? We must examine that throughout our lives.
근데 그게 주님의 계획과 맞아야 되고요. 주님이 원하시는 방향과 또 맞아야 됩니다.
But that must match with the will and the direction of God.
삶의 목적이 주님의 계획과 주님의 방향과 맞게 될 때에 그게 하나님은 모든 것을 더하여 주신다라고 말씀하고 있는 것입니다.
When my life plans and my life goal is set on the same direction with the plans of God,
하나님이 우리 인생을 한 하나님
Then God will absolutely guide us, then what is the plan of God inside of our lives?
목적으로 삼고 나가기를 원하시는 부분들이 무엇입니까?
Then what is it that God wants us to hold on to inside of the direction that we live in?
우리를 하나님의 자녀로 만드셨습니다.
God has made us His child.
하나님의 자녀인 우리에게 성령께서 내주하시고 오늘 또 인도하시고 또 역사하시게 되어 있습니다.
And to the children of God, God still today indwells, guides, and gives us the filling of the Holy Spirit. Why does God work inside of our lives, give us the filling of the Holy Spirit? Our praise team gave this praise. Gave the praise that we have already won the victory. God is making us live as the life of a witness.
어떤 자리에 있다할지라도 어떤 직업을 갖고 있다할지라도 어떤 위치에 있다할지라도 우리 인생의 소원과 우리의 삶의 목적은 바로 증인의 삶, 전도자의 삶을 걸어가는 것입니다.
No matter what kind of place that we're seated in or what kind of job we might have, God wants to make us as the witness.
만약 그것이 아니고 다른 것이 우리의 삶의 목적과 방향이 되어 있다면은 결국은 성취된 이후에 넘어지고 실패하게 되어 있습니다.
If this is not the case and other things are our plans and our direction, then we will fulfill everything and have success and later on we will later on have void inside of us. Many people inside of the world, they work diligently and put their efforts and they work hard and have success. But you're able to see that even though they have success, later on they are filled with void and they later on fail. But if the things that they have planned are not fulfilled, then they will fall into this anxiety, discouragement, and despair.
흐름, 흐름, 흐름,
and that is why we must never lose hold of the stream of the word, prayer, and evangelism.
그 언약 붙잡고 전도자의 삶을 사는 것이 우리의 삶의 목적이 되어야 합니다.
And holding on to that covenant and living our lives as a witness.
오늘 새벽에 제가 말씀을 드렸습니다. 여러분 어디에 있는가를 점검해 봐야.
So I told you in the early morning prayer service.
어떤 길을 가고 있는 것인가를 점검해 봐야.
We must examine ourselves.
정말로 하나님 원하시는
길에서. What kind of path am I taking, and where am I standing?
하나님 원하시는 길을 가고 있는가를 점검해 봐야.
Am I going the path where God wants me to go? We must examine that.
그러면 하나님께서 우리의 모든 것들을 책임지시게.
Then God will take care of everything else.
하나님께서 우리를 향한 계획이 무엇일까요?
What is the plan of God towards us?
충만함을 우리에게 약속하셨을까요?
Why did God promise us the filling of the Holy Spirit?
땅 끝까지 이르러 증인되는 삶을 살도록 하시기 위해서.
So that we may live the life of a witness. He has promised us the filling of the Holy Spirit.
그렇다면 우리의 모든 삶의 방향이 땅 끝까지 증인되어지는 이 일에.
Then all of our direction and the plans of our lives must set the direction to this, to become the witnesses to the ends of the earth.
교회가 전도와 선교 세계 복음화 때문에 우리 교회가 오늘까지 하나님 인도받는 가운데 달려왔습니다.
The elder prayed today, and he, holding onto the covenant of world evangelization, we have come this far.
하나님께서 우리에게 소원을 두고 달려오게.
And God has placed this will inside of us so that we can come this far, holding on to the covenant of becoming the witnesses to the ends of the earth.
정말로 하나님의 손과 계획이 여러분 마음 속에서 떨어지지 아니하고 끝까지 주님의 귀한 축복된 역사의 길을 걸어가는 저와 여러분 되기를 주여 여러분.
I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you and I become the people who, to the end, go to this path.
오늘 예수님이 십자가에서 죽으시고 무덤에 누우신 장면이 나오고 있습니다.
In today's passage, you're able to see that Jesus was crucified and died, and he was buried in the tomb.
의미가 무엇인가를 살펴봐야.
Then we must take a look at what is the reason of Jesus's death.
그리스도로 말미암아 우리에게 구원을 주셨는데 그 구원을 이루는 일에 있어서 죽음의 의미가 어떤 의미를 가지고 있는가.
Through Christ, God has given us salvation. Then through the death, we must see the reason why Jesus had to die. Then we are able to enjoy Christ more deeply and abundantly. So first,
참 사람의 몸을 입고 오셔서 십자가에 죽으셔야 하는 이유가 무엇입니까?
So what is the reason why he must come in a true human body and die on the cross?
사람이었음을 증거하는 것이었습니다.
So it was evidence that he was true man.
예수님이 동정녀 탄생하셨습니다.
Jesus was born of a virgin Mary.
인성을 가지고 이 땅에 오셨다는 말이죠.
So with human nature he has come to this world and he died on the cross.
근데 초대교회 당시에는 이 사실들을 부인하는 단체들이 많았습니다.
But during the age of the early church there were many organizations that denied this.
오늘 새벽에 우리가 골로새서를 잠시 살펴보았는데
And in the early morning prayer service we took a look at Corinthians.
사상이 들어와서 예수 그리스도가 이 땅에
And in the Corinthian church
인성을 가지고 오신 부분들을 부인하는 그런 사상들이
There were the people with ideology of Gnosticism. Who denied the fact that Jesus was born of a virgin and died on the cross and rose from the dead. So why does it mean by denying the human nature of Jesus? It is denying the fact that Jesus died on the cross and resurrected. And they're denying the fact that Jesus gave us the forgiveness of sin. If you see in 1 John 4:2, it says,
예수 그리스도께서 육체로 오신 것을 시인하는 영마다 하나님께 속한 것이다 했어.
So Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God. By this you know the spirit of God, every spirit that confesses. So it says that he has come in his flesh. And whoever confesses that, they are of God. In Isaiah 7:14, already this was prophesied that Jesus will come. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel. So Jesus was born of a virgin. So every time we confess, he was born of a Virgin Mary. So this is the confession of our faith. So many people, because they're always denying the fact of Jesus, they're denying the fact that he was born of a Virgin Mary. But Jesus, he was born of a virgin and he was incarnated in flesh. And he's God. If you see Matthew 1:23, he used these terms. So this is what was fulfilled. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel.
In John 1:14,
it says, so the Word was God, and he was clothed in flesh and come, and that was Jesus. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us.
그리고 빌립보 2장 6절에서 8절에 십자가에 죽기 위해서 결국은 이 땅에 성육신 하셨다라는 사실을 말하고 있는 것입니다.
And if you see in Philippians 2:6-8, Jesus has come incarnated in flesh to die on the cross.
2장 7절에 보면은 사람으로 사람들 아니 사람들과 같이
So in verse 6 he has come.
그러면 2장 8절에 말씀하고 있죠.
He has come, and in verse 8, let us read together. And being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Why did he come incarnated? It tells us that he has come to die.
사람의 몸을 입고 이 땅에 오셔서 예수님께서 십자가에 못 박혀
And in a human form, he was crucified on the cross and died. Then why did he have to be crucified on the cross?
하나님이시기 때문에 그냥 말로서 내가 너희들의 모든 죄를 용서한다 그렇게 하면 될 거 아닙니까?
Because he is God, he could have just said, "I forgive your sins."
근데 왜 성육신하셨습니까?
But why did he come incarnated?
하나님이 사람 되시다는 그 자체가 고통이죠.
Coming in a human form, that itself is suffering. But why did he come incarnated in flesh? And why did it face suffering and be despised and crucified on the cross? It is to solve the problems of sin, death, and the spiritual status of mankind. Adam and Eve, they gave unbelief.
인간에게 죽음과 죄의 종으로 사단의 종이라는 신분의 변화를 가져왔습니다.
And the sin of disobedience has brought the change of status, being enslaved to sin and death and Satan.
사단의 종이라는 신분의 변화를 가져오게 된 것입니다.
The sin of disobedience has brought this kind of change into our spiritual status. So in Genesis 3:1-7, mankind were separated from God. And in Genesis 2:17, there were death to mankind. It says, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the days that you eat of it you shall surely die. So because of that unbelief, they were spiritually dead.
죄의 종이라고 로마서 6장 17절에 말씀하고
In Romans 6:17 that is why we have mankind have become slaves of sin. It says who you who were once slaves of sin. And if you see in John 8:44 you are of your father the devil. Because we have the status of Satan. Inside of the schedule of disaster, people have no choice but to live inside of failure.
이 죄 문제를 해결하기 위해서는 피를 흘리는 제사를 드려야 하는 것입니다.
So to solve this problem of sin, we have to give a sacrifice that sheds blood. In Leviticus 17:11. For the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you. And in Hebrews 9:22, indeed under the law, almost everything is purified with blood. And without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. To solve the problems of our sin, we have to give life. That is why we give. He has told us to give the blood sacrifice.
보혈의 능력은 우리를 죄와 죽음과 영적인 신분의 문제를 해결하시는 속죄의 죽음이었습니다.
So the power of the blood that is shed on the cross by Jesus has set us free from sin, death, and the changes of the spiritual status. In today's message, there will be a lot of Bible verses. So look this up and have make this your own and have assurance.
어떤 분들은 이제 설교 중에 나가는 메시지 가지고 성경 구절만 녹취하는 분이 계시더라고요.
There are people who just write down the Bible verses inside of the passage.
녹취하기 힘듭니다라고 이야기.
And they will come to me and say, there are so many passages, so it's hard for us to write it all down. So look this all up. And I really hope that you have the assurance of faith. In 2 Corinthians 5:21, it says, For our sake he made him to be a sin who knew no sin so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
우리로 하여금 그 안에서 하나님의 의가 되게 하기 위해서라고 말씀했습니다.
So why did he make himself sin? It is so that he shows that he is God. In Ephesians 1:7, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses. And in Colossians 1:13, he has delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom. And in verse 14, it says, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. In 1 Peter 3:18, let us all read together. For Christ also suffered once for his sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit. Hallelujah.
예수 그리스도의 십자가의 죽음은 우리의 죄, 죽음, 영적인 신분의 문제를 해결한 속죄의 죽음이었습니다.
Jesus dying on the cross, it is to solve all of our sin, curses, death, and the spiritual status. And he died on the cross so that he can solve the curses of all of the laws. In Deuteronomy 21:23, the hangman is cursed by God, it says.
예수가 바로 하나님께 저주받은 자라는 사실을 알았기 때문에 예수를 믿지 않았습니다. 그런데 주님이 직접 찾아오셔서 부활하신 주님이
But Peter did not believe that Jesus was Christ when he was crucified on the cross, but because he thought that Jesus was cursed by God, but the resurrected Christ has come back to Peter and showed his love. And so the cross proves the love of God. In Galatians 3:13, Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law. So he has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Yes, Jesus was crucified on the cross. And he has took care of all of the curses of the law and has given us salvation. And so that he can make us the children of God, he has died on the cross. Galatians 4:4-6. God sent forth his son, born of woman, born under the law. And then if you see in verse 6, it says, the spirit of his son into our hearts crying, Abba, Father. So through Jesus Christ, now we are able to call God, Abba, Father. To those who believe in Jesus Christ and accept, they will become the children of God. Now they have become the, we have become the status where the Holy Spirit dwells inside of us. In John 14:16, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to be with you forever. So at becoming the children of God, the Holy Spirit dwells inside of us forever. In 1 Corinthians 3:16, it tells us, do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? And through the cross of Jesus Christ, and he has given us the blessing where we can completely enjoy the blessing of the blood sacrifice, Matthew 1:21. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Hebrews 9:12, it says, he entered once for all this into the holy place, not by means of the blood of goats and calves, but by means of his own blood, thus securing an eternal redemption. So blood of Jesus Christ has given us the eternal victory. In Hebrews 10:12, but when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God. Jesus Christ shedding his blood, he has become the ransom and the atonement. And he has completed that, so we no longer have to give blood sacrifice. And Jesus Christ dying on the cross, it is to show us the love of God. Romans 5:8, it tells us, but God showed his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Cross is the evidence of the love of God. The love of God is to give us salvation. If you see 1 John 4:9, in this the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. That's how the love of God was revealed.
사랑은 여기 있으니 우리가 하나님을 사랑한 것이 아니다 있습니다.
And it's not us who love God. It is that God loved us.
우리를 속하기 위하여 화목 제물로 그 아들을 보내셨다 말씀했습니다.
And sent His Son to be the
그리스도의 십자가에 죽으심은 하나님이 우리를 얼마나 사랑하시는가 그 사실을 우리에게 나타나에 보이신 하나님의 사랑의 증거인 것입니다.
And that is the evidence that God loves us.
여러분, 이 그리스도를 여러분 모시고 있습니까?
And are you guys
여러분은 죄로 인한 죄의
worshiping this Jesus Christ?
신분이 마귀의 종이 아닙니다.
Your status is not the status of Satan anymore.
율법의 저주에서 해방된 하나님의 자녀입니다.
You guys are the children of God that are set free from the curses of law.
완전한 승리의 축복을 그리스도로 말미암아 우리에게 주시고 오늘 또
And through Christ God has given us the eternal victory and with his love he is today holding on to us.
그 사실들을 이번 주 한 주간 그리스도의 죽음을 통해서 우리에게 얻어진 구원의 축복인 걸 아시고 그 사실을 누리는 누림 속에 들어가기를 주의 이름으로
축원합니다. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you go inside of the blessing and the enjoyment of the cross why Jesus died for us and enjoy the love of God. Second, Jesus' death is the fulfillment of the word.
사단이 예수님을 십자가에 못 박은 줄 알지만은 그러나 그것으로 말미암아 오히려
Satan
사단의 머리가 깨뜨려진 것.
Might think that he crucified Jesus on the cross, but because of that, Satan's head was crushed.
사단들이 예수님을 십자가에 못 박으라 해서 결국 십자가에
The Pharisees and the Jews they crucified Jesus on the cross.
하나님이 그리스도로 말미암아 우리에게 승리를 주시
But that wasn't the work of Satan, but God through that has given us true victory.
예수님의 십자가에 죽으심은 창세기 3장 15절의 성취입니다.
Jesus' death was the fulfillment of Genesis 3:15. The offspring of woman will crush the head of the serpent.
예수님이 사단의 머리를 상하게 하며 죄와 죽음, 저주의 모든 문제를 해결하심에 대한 약속의 성취가 바로 예수님의 십자가의 죽음인 것입니다.
Jesus Christ crucified on the cross was the fulfillment of the word where on the cross he has crushed the head of the serpent and solved all of our sin, death, and curses. In Exodus 3:18, so what became more in depth of Genesis 3:15 was Exodus 3:18 and that word was fulfilled, the Passover. So through the Passover, all of the Israelites were able to come out of Egypt and they were set free from the hands of Pharaoh. And this word was fulfilled on the cross.
고난의 종으로 오실 것을 이사야 53장에 말씀하시고 있습니다.
If you see in Isaiah 53,
그 고난의 종으로 오시는 예수님의 말씀의 성취가 바로 예수님의 죽으심이라는 사실을 우리에게 말씀하고 있습니다.
And the fulfillment of that word is the death of Jesus. It says, but he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed.
우리가 어떻게 우리의 모든 삶 속에서 평안을 누리고
How can we enjoy peace and how can we receive healing inside of our lives?
예수 그리스도의 죽으심으로 말미암아 이 말씀이 그대로
Jesus Christ dying on the cross, this was fulfilled.
그리고 예수 그리스도의 죽음은
And the death of Jesus is the promise of God where he will abolish death. Matthew 27:62-66, if you see here, people gathered in front of Pilate. And they asked to Pilate, the people who are deceiving are speaking, when Jesus was alive, Jesus said that he will come back to life in 3 days.
그래서 결국은 그들은 어떤 면에서 실제로 그렇게 될지 모른다는 그런 사실 속에서
So because they were thinking that this might happen, so they protected the tomb.
예수님이 기적을 행하시고 말씀대로 이루어질 것이라는 부분들을 마음에 알고 그들은 무덤을 지켰던 것입니다.
So they knew the miracles that Jesus will fulfill, so they protected the tomb.
하나님이심을 성경에서 말씀하고 있습니다.
And you're able to see that in the Bible, Jesus abolished death.
이제는 우리 구주 그리스도 예수의
Second Timothy 1:10, and which now has been manifested through the appearing of our Savior Christ Jesus and abolished death.
예수 그리스도는 우리의 사망의 문제를 해결하신 것입니다.
Jesus Christ has solved our death problem of death. And 1 Corinthians 15:54 tells us
삼키고 이기리라고 기록된 말씀이 이루어지리라 했어.
It says then shall come to pass saying and written death is swallowed up in victory.
말씀했어요.
And death, where is your victory?
예수 그리스도로 말미암아 없어졌다는 사실을 이야기하고 있는 것입니다.
So it is telling us that death was destroyed, abolished through the death of Jesus Christ.
생명의 역사를 우리 안에 시작해 하신 것입니다.
And he has given us new life.
그래서 이사야 25장 8절에 말씀하고 있죠.
In Isaiah 25:8 it tells us
사망을 영원히 피하시리라 말씀했어요.
He will swallow up death forever.
여러분 사망을 영원히 피하신다는 말은 무슨 말입니까?
What does it mean by he will swallow up death forever? It means that he will give us eternal life.
사망의 세력을 잡은 자를 멸하신 사건이 바로 예수 그리스도의 죽음에 통해서 우리에게 그 일들이 이루어진 것입니다.
Through the death of Jesus Christ, the works arose of destroying the one that holds the authority of death. Jesus Christ crucifying on the being crucified on the cross, he has abolished death. And in Hebrews 2:14, it tells us, through death, he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is the devil. And in verse 15, and deliver all those who through fear of death were subject to lifelong slavery.
사망의 문제를 피하신 그리스도가
Christ, who abolished the authority of death, is now with you and I. This world, the authority of death rules over it. That is why everybody fears death and they are enslaved by it. And who has the authority of death? It is Satan. Satan, the devil, he's making all the people fear death and enslaving them. But the authority of death and the authority and the place of death, Christ being crucified on the cross has solved all of that problem. That is why when we are living on through the Jesus Christ who has abolished death and living as the witness of Christ, that is the life of those who have faith. I really hope that you guys go inside of the life enjoying the kingdom of God. What does it mean by enjoying the kingdom of God? Jesus called his disciples and told him, repent for the heaven is near. In Matthew 6, if you see, Jesus taught a prayer to his disciples and pray for the kingdom to come. In Matthew 6:33, it tells us something very important. First, seek his kingdom and his righteousness, and everything else will be added on to you. And right before Jesus ascended into heaven, for 40 days, he spoke of the works pertaining to the kingdom of God. So what is the blessing that we must really enjoy as we live on?
사망을 피하신 하나님의 나라의 역사들을 우리는 당연히 누려가야 합니다.
We must rightfully enjoy the kingdom of God that abolishes the authority of death. How can we enjoy the kingdom of God? We keep on speaking about this partisan journey and guidepost, holding on to this, praying. That is how you enjoy the kingdom of God. God told Abraham, I will be with you, and no one will be able to harm you.
그걸 무슨 말합니까?
What does that mean?
내가 너와 함께하는데 너를 당할 자 없겠다 말씀했어.
I will be with you, so no one will be able to harm you. That is the partisan. And again, told Abraham.
내가 너로 말하여 천하 만민이 복을 받게 하겠다.
And through you, all nations will be blessed. And that is the journey.
모든 여정에
inside of all of our journey, through me, the works of all the people receiving blessings will arise. And that is the journey that is given inside of Christ. And to Abraham, again, tells him to go to the land that I will show you. That is the guidepost. Go to the land that I will show you.
하나님의 나라의 일이 이루어지는 그 가나안 땅으로 가라고 말씀하신 것입니다.
God is telling Abraham to go to the land of Canaan where the kingdom of God will be established.
허감의 근세를 깨뜨리시고 사단의 나라를 깨뜨리시고 하나님의 나라로 우리에게 축복하시기 위해서 그리스도가 오신 사실 알고
knowing that Christ has come
그냥 축복 속에 들어가기를 주의 이름으로 축원합니다.
Destroying the world, the authority of this world and the kingdom of Satan.
나라를 누리는 기도입니다.
So we must enjoy the kingdom of God, that kingdom of God. And to enjoy that kingdom of God, it is the partisan journey and the guidepost. I will tell you one more thing. The promises that God has given us through Jesus Christ's death was fulfilled. Day by day, if you are the people of God, then hold on to the word of God, and you must go out, having meditating upon the word of God and praying. Then God will show you the works of God and fulfill His word. So when we are faced with problems and situations, may through the word, may you have victory. I bless you in the name of the Lord, then that path will be yours.
함께 찬양하며 기도하는 시간 갖도록 하겠습니다. 찬양은 어느 날 나는 알았네 주가 그리스도이심을 함께 찬양하겠고요. 기도 제목들 좀 보십시다. 그리스도의 죽음의 의미를 아는 전도 제자의 기도입니다. 같이 한번 읽어볼까요? 우리 인생의 방향과 목적이 전도자의 길에 있게 하옵소서. 그리스도 죽음을 통해서 얻어진 구원을 기도로 누리게 하옵소서. 사망을 피하시고 새로운 생명, 영원한 생명을 보장해 주신 그리스도 안에서 모든 것 보게 하옵소서. 기도 제목들 여러분 마음에 담으시면서 함께 찬양하겠습니다. 어느 날 나는 알았네. 어느